From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Shannon Moss.
I'm Norm Karkos. A man from Lisbon facing a number of charges, including attempted murder, is set to go on trial today.
Police say back in September 2008, Bartolo Ford stole a dump truck and then led police on a chase, eventually ramming into an officer's cruiser. News 8's Dave Guthrow has more from Androscoggin County Superior Court.
Well, the trial of 49-year-old Bartolo Ford of Lisbon is set to begin this morning here at Androscoggin County Superior Court. He faces a charge of aggravated attempted murder, two counts of aggravated criminal mischief, as well as two counts of reckless conduct. And all of this stems from an incident that took place back in September of 2008 when Ford led police on a chase that began here in Auburn and ended up in Poland. Along the way, he ran into several police cruisers, cars, and was actually shot at and struck by one of the officers along the way. He ended up in Poland. He was captured, gave himself up at a forest in Poland by police. And again, his trial begins here later this morning. We'll have a full update on those proceedings later on today on WMTW.com and full coverage tonight on News 8 at 6. For now in Auburn, Dave Guthrow for News 8 Now.
We're about 2 months away from the gubernatorial election, and a major union has thrown its support behind Maine's Democratic candidate for governor. The Maine State Employees Association says it's backing Senate President Libby Mitchell in her bid to be Maine's next governor. The union sent questionnaires to all five candidates for governor, and the candidates were also asked to participate in a number of interviews with union members. The union says it's endorsing Mitchell because she has the ability to work effectively with members of all political parties. The group represents more than 12,000 state employees. And a Republican candidate and current Waterville mayor, Paula Page, spoke at Waterville's monthly Rotary meeting yesterday. LePage focusing on several hot-button items, including the need to elect someone who will lead the way to limit spending, lower taxes, and help Mainers earn livable wages. In a recent poll of likely voters, LePage is leading with 38% of the vote.
South Portland City Council one step closer to sending a $44 million bond to voters in November. Last night, council approved a second reading of the measure, which would help pay for the major renovations to South Portland High School. 60-year-old school faces probation if several structural issues are not fixed soon. The principal of an elementary school in Lynn, Massachusetts, is vowing to start classes on time after vandals damaged the school. Over the weekend, the vandals opened fire extinguishers, spraying them all over the floors and hallways of Callahan Elementary School. The principal says something was damaged in every room, from classrooms to the auditorium to the gymnasium. Police say the damage is so extensive that the school is considered a crime scene.
All right, a man from New Hampshire who was taking out his trash got the surprise of his life after an encounter with a dumpster diver. We're not talking about another person, however. Jeff Allard of North Conway telling game wardens that he was tossing his trash into a dumpster when a bear, of all things, climbed out. Because it was dark, Allard said he did not notice the bear inside, and as you can imagine, both were startled. The bear scratched Allard's shoulder, knocking him down to the ground, and the bear ran into the woods. What did you say? We've had snakes. What else?
We've had skunks and skunks. Lobster traps. Snakes and washing machines. That could have been a grisly situation.
Good one. That's it for this update.
We'll see you in a few.